Hello everybody. Time is short, so I'm just gonna use my t-shirt just to say hello to everyone. A lot of people are talking about Indian people. I'm scared to talk about Indian people because I've been watching Facebook and all your guys are becoming dangerous. What happened, Keeganing all the O's and all that? Kicking the people, hey. There's a stereotype that colored people stab and all that. No. You forget about One Eye Bobby. You must worry about Sifa Kumar now. These guys are getting too dangerous. Seriously, you'll actually help me out a lot. It's like when I'm walking through Gateway, the Indian ladies, they don't hide their bag from me anymore and all. Look, guys, thank you. It's like life's actually becoming good for colored people. Seriously, like, you know, there's one question. Yeah, like the name Sifa Kumar, and I want to ask you all, I saw that you're changing your names now, like, you know, to John and Patrick and all that, yeah. Thanks a lot, because it confuses us. Why? We can say Sifa Kumar. I'll tell you the truth, right? I worked in a company, NetBank, for 10 years, right? I'm calling this guy Kevin for 10 years. When I'm leaving, I find out his real name, Sifa Kumar. And then I met an Indian chick too, nice, you know, those the ones with the nice palms, not the SpongeBob ones, you know, those that are eating pork. I ask her, what's her name? She tells me, no, her name's Tammy. Tammy what? Tammy Naidu. I'm okay, cool, but we couldn't talk. Now, you know, us new age kids will invite you on Facebook, I mean, your inbox, you know what I mean? When I get home, I'm searching millions of Naidus, I can't find her nowhere. I'm like, to the one that got away. Then she invites me. Guess what's her real name? Tamenri Naidu. Why are you doing this to us? I'll tell you, I went to a doctor, right? Indian doctor. I went to the doctor, and when they called me, they're like, Daryl Williams. I go inside, female, and then she says, Daryl Williams, that's a very American name. I was like, what you mean American? Can you not see I'm colored? She's like, no, I studied in America. There's a lot of Daryl Williamses running around in the USA. So I was okay, I felt offended, so I said, okay, then I want to ask you a question. Why are Indian people naming their children after body parts? She's like, what you mean? I said, you don't know Nana. Bala. Cookie. And your surname's Ready. Okay, enough, right? Take care, right? Let me rather talk what's nice about Indian people. You see, when you're Indian, you're a pure race. Same when you're white, you're a pure race. You know what I mean? Like you don't know the struggles, me being colored, what we go through. Like, for instance, when you're having a child, you basically know what your child's gonna look like. You know, dark straight hair. Same when you're white. You know what I mean? Hey, but when you're colored, never know what the light is gonna look like. You can have two fair colors to get a dog child. Now you don't know what? You don't know if your wife was cheating on you or what? Plus, so now you're just hoping for the good year. You know, it's like a lucky pack. It's like he's putting a jackpot wheel. Crusade. And even like you know, in your heritage, in your family tree, you know it was Indian writer that came with the ship, you know? You mean it's white, so they came and colonized, you know? But when you colored, at some point in your heritage, something had to happen. Like someone had to take a walk on the wild side, you know what I mean? I'll give you the backstory. My great-grandfather was a white man. His name was Matthias Frederick Willemse, hardcore Afrikaner, and he married a black Shangaan woman, right? Oh, boy, what a story. A couple of backseat jobs after that I came out, right? Now I'm yours problem. But you know what's exciting? What's exciting? You know, you can basically see the features that you got from each side. You know what I mean? Like when I look in the mirror, I can see, well, this hair, well, it's not crooked, but it's not straight. Something in the middle, you know? Like I can do that Indian hairstyle. You know the one that goes to the side? It's called the M2 off ramp. But my colored brothers don't like me because they move me with a spaghetti junction. You know what I mean? That's the hair, even these eyes, these green eyes, it's not contacts, Indian people, it's not. It's real green eyes coming straight from Matthias. That's what I got from him. I can't really show you what I got from the black Shangaan child. It's not that type of show. Plus, so Indian guys don't like that joke. I think it's too big for them. Just goes over their heads, huh? But yeah, bigger now, you know. I try to do new age things, like, you know, when I grew up being colored, it was hectic. Like, when we were sick, we didn't have things, you know. Like, even like when we were sick, we didn't have a basic thing like medical aid. Like, my child's nose will be running, I must run to the doctor. Hey, when I was sick, they just give you anything to make you better. Yeah, you know those Dutch medicines? Yeah? For wood middle and interest triples. I got a running stomach, they make their own remedy to make. Have you ever drank flour and water? They will take flour and water, drink it, it's gonna bind your stomach. Confused me, I'm like, I had a running stomach, now you giving me flour and water, it's like a, now I'm shitting a soggy Maquinia over here. Was it? But right, I have to go, I just want to get your opinion. Anybody happy with our new president, Cyril Ramaphosa? I'm happy, I'll tell you why I'm happy. It's just like, as Kwanda was talking about Zuma, this is my thing, right? I don't have a lot wrong with him, but this is my thing. I'm just, don't embarrass me on the world stage, please. Because when you're talking there, you're talking for me and all of us, you know what I mean? Like, you know, when he's on the world stage and he's asked the difficult question and he doesn't know what to do, he just goes, No, you know what I mean? Like, you need to inspire a nation. I tell you what, you know what, it made me cross. I said, you know what? All these MPs, all those madam speakers, all of those people in parliament, they all need to get fired, and comedians should run the country. Because after all, it does take a clown to run a circus, right? Because that's what they're doing in parliament. If I'm on the hot seat and they ask me a hard question, they'll be like, Daryl, tell me, what happened between Julius Malema and Jacob Zuma? They were part of the same party. They were fighting for black excellence. You know, they're fighting. Now they're loggerheads now. There's this one, there's the EFF, there's the ANC. What happened? Tell me. Now, even if I don't know the answer, I'm going to get creative and say, you want to know what happened? I'll tell you what happened. Now this is a story all about how his life got twisted upside down. So if you really want to know if we are state captured, take a look at how AJ got Gupta gated. In Western Kandla, born and raised in the showers where he spent most of his days, chilling out, relaxing and acting all cool, dreaming of the tail on a fire pool, when a couple of guys who were wearing all red started making trouble in the neighborhood. He got in one little fight and his mom said, however, it's time you start running from the Julius Malema. My name's Daryl Williams, please welcome back your host.